Away from that, the Uganda and Somali relations became popular after the former deployed military troops to help in the fight against the Al-Shabaab terrorist group. Prior to this, Uganda has since the 19th century hosted Somalis who arrived here with British colonialists. In this report, we speak to them freely living in Uganda and now prefer living in Uganda than Somalia.
People, they know Somali, they are fleeing Somalia in 1991, but it's not like that. Somali community, they came to this country 18th century. Somali and Nubi, they came to this country one time with the tour in the colonial, British colonial, with Captain Lugar.
The fall of Somalia's former president, Mohamed Said Barre, in 1991 and the subsequent political instabilities opened up a new chapter in the Somali mobility across the world. Many of them sought refugee in neighboring countries, including Uganda. They settled in different areas, one of which is Kisenyi.
Because our host community, they are good people. The Uganda government, they are good people. And we feel like we are living in Somalia. This is our country. So we are the one who built this, you know, the Kisenyi, invested. So, and now we are happy. We are happy to live here.
According to Uganda's Office of the Prime Minister, between 2008 and 2017, the number of registered Somali refugees in the country soared from 8,239 to over 41,000. They prepare and eat their local foods like camels. The major problem faced by migrant Somalis is the application for permanent residence.
Applying the permanent, you have to be stay more than 15 years. 15 years. So that's a little bit difficult because you see, when you get the resettlement in third country like Europe or America, you can get the nationality, the passport, 4 or 5 years. So here we are Africans and we don't know, if you are not staying less than 15 years, you can't get.
Somalis' integration to the community, they have even tested and won political leadership like Jini Muhammad Hassan, the vice chairperson of Kasato zone in Kisenyi.
I think so, even I have another country. This is my first country.
Okay.
Yes. I like Uganda so much.
Yeah.
Better than even my country.
Beyond politics, leaders say there are even intermarriages between Somalis and Ugandans.
15 years back was very bit tricky and difficult, but now we are same community now.
We are one people.
The integrated marriage already happened. We have the business share. We work together. Dowry. Brief. In the our Somalia, when you are in Somalia, dowry is different. 1 kg of gold, 100 camel, maybe money, $1,000, maybe goats, maybe cows. But now, the things is changing now. So it's understanding, matter of understanding now.
Though the dowry paid for a Somali woman may not be as high as before, Jini Muhammad Hassan believes Ugandan men may find it hard to take care of Somali women in marriage.
I don't think so. Men for Uganda, they can manage Somali lady. Because of the economic and
story by Benon Ojambo and Titus Kakembo for the news in Kisenyi, Kampala.